हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 51 एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट यूनिट नंबर 6. दिस इज लास्ट यूनिट ऑफ दिस सेमेस्टर ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल इंजीनियरिंग 2. इन दिस यूनिट पर्टिकुलरली वी विल टॉकिंग अबाउट और वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट एंड इट्स मेथड ऑफ सैम्पलिंग, न्यूट्रलाइजेशन, प्रोपोर्शन and overall terms, which, what overall terms include industrial waste. We will discuss this unit. So first we will see what exact syllabus of this unit, then we will start this unit. So you can see here unit number 6, that is industrial waste water treatment. In this particular industrial water treatment, we will learn about method of sampling, what are the method of sampling, that means how to take a sample for the treatment process, and what are the method of sampling which we have taken from the industrial waste. Then how to equalization, neutralization, proportion techniques which we adopt in the industrial waste treatment process. Then application of preliminary, primary and secondary treatment for industrial wastewater as per the CPCB norms, Central Pollution Control Board's norms. What are the preliminary, primary, secondary treatment for the industrial wastewater? This is the part first, which we will discuss in this unit. Then second one part, that is source of wastewater generation from the manufacturing process. So many of now rapid days, there are many of industries which we are produce different types of products which may related to the water or so what the source of water and what are the manufacturing process after the using the that water, what will be the characteristic of that effluent which came from that particular industries. Then difference method and the disposal of effluent for the following industries: sugar, dairy and the distillery, which are standard as per the CPCBC. So particularly in this unit, we will discuss about what are the sampling, equalization, neutralization taking as per the CPCB, and second one part which related to the wastewater generate from the industry after using the which type of the industries and what are the character influence. So in the particular units, we will discuss about industrial wastewater treatment. So in today's lecture, we will discuss a few points, that is introductions, then second one objectives, then third source of wastewater, then waste characterization, sampling, location of sampling, types of sampling or samples. So first introduction part, you can see here day by day period rapid growth of population. So that why rapidly increasing industrialization of our countries? So कदाचित तुम्ही जर बघितलं आताच्या काही दिवसात रॅपिड पॉप्युलेशन खूप वाढत आहे, आणि जशी पॉप्युलेशन वाढत आहे तसे इंडस्ट्रियलायझेशन ऑफ द कंट्रीज वाढत आहे. त्यामुळं सो ऑल द इंडस्ट्री रिक्वायर्ड द ह्यूज अमाऊंट ऑफ वेस्ट वॉटर, ह्यूज अमाऊंट ऑफ वॉटर फॉर डिफरंट इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोसेस. ओके, सो इंडस्ट्रीज यूज वॉटर दॅट ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम वॉटर ट्रीटमेंट सिस्टम फॉर व्हरायटी ऑफ द पर्पज सच ॲज फॉर मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग प्रोसेस दे रिक्वायर द अमाऊंट, ह्यूज अमाऊंट वॉटर. And then for heating, then for the cooling, then as carrier of raw materials, then as carrier of waste matter, as a solvent, the resulting water is then classified as a waste water. Okay, so you know that in our industries require the huge amount of water for the purpose of, you can just seen at that purpose for manufacturing purpose, and heating purpose, cooling purpose, carrier purpose, and as a resulting after coming that water will be classified as a वेस्ट वॉटर. मोस्टली तुम्हाला माहिती आहे की इंडस्ट्रीमध्ये जशी काही इंडस्ट्रियलायझेशन होत आहे त्याच्यामुळे जास्तीत जास्त पाण्याचा यूज होतो, पाणी वापरलं जात आहे. पर्टिक्युलर ते पाणी कशासाठी वापरलं जातं की मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग प्रोसेस करण्यासाठी, मॅन्युफॅक्चर करण्यासाठी, नंतर हिटिंग गरम करण्यासाठी, हिटिंग करण्यासाठी, आणि कुलिंगसाठी लागतं पाणी, रॉ मटेरियलसाठी पाणी लागतं, कधी तो वेस्ट वॉटरसाठी लागतं, आणि फायनली सॉल्वंटसाठी सुद्धा पाणी लागतं, आणि फायनली जे काही ते पाणी एवढ्या प्रोसेसमधून निघत राहिलं आपण वेस्ट इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वॉटर असं म्हणतो. So what is industrial wastewater exactly? The question will be rising in your mind. So industrial waste include a liquid, solid and the gases. We are presently concerned with liquid part, which is commonly known as industrial wastewater. mostly, so everyone having their own questions in their mind. So what is exactly industrial wastewater? Industrial wastewater included what liquid, solid and the gases. And we are presently want to focus concerned with the liquid part only, okay, which is commonly known as the industrial wastewater. So wastewater, which is generated as by the product from the process unit operating or having constituted, which can be cause harmful and the hazardous effect of the human, animal, plant, aquatic and the microbial life, different life form of the earth. सो मोस्टली बहुतेकांच्या मनात प्रश्न असतो की इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वॉटर कशाला म्हणायचं की इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वॉटर म्हणजेच काय इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वॉटरचे थ्री फॉर्म असतात लिक्विड सॉलिड अँड गॅसेस मोस्टली प्रेझेंटली कन्सर्न विथ आपण लिक्विड पार्टवर डिस्कस करणार आहोत द लिक्विड पार्ट इंडस्ट्रीमधून जो निघतो विच इज कॉल्ड द इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वॉटर म्हणतात ओके मोस्टली दॅट वॉटर विच जनरेटेड थ्रू द मॅन्युफॅक्चर प्रोसेस कुलिंग प्रोसेस अँड ऑल द प्रोडक्ट इफेक्ट अँड आफ्टर कमिंग दॅट वॉटर जे पाणी बाहेर निघतं त्याच्यामुळे काय होतं harmful hazardous effect human being work ki animal work ki aquatic life ro hota acha different je ki human life hai tacha also effect ho the waste water cha so that water which colored industrial waste water so these are the source of waste water you can see here this is the industry waste water this is textile industries which can be a source of industrial water then landfill leakage then glass industries catering industries primary printing industry carrying a business then semiconductor industries then pharmaceutical industries the automobile industries refinery metal industries and the shredding facility and the textile industries these are the source of industries which those we are came the industrial wastewater so what are the exact objective of this treatment plant or the industrial wastewater The principal objective of industrial wastewater treatment is generally to allow industry effluent to be disposed of without danger to human health and unacceptable damage to the natural environment. So main purpose of industrial treatment is that very simple. So industrial wastewater is a very hazardous to human being. After treating that water, it will be safe for the human being as well as animal or aquatic life. That purpose the effluent of industrial waste should be without danger to the human health mostly first objective hai industrial waste treatment plants ki industry madna je vinigral ghan pani hi human being sathi khub ghatak asta ana asa ghatak nasava tacha treatment karun te pani naturally environment madhe ki natural stream madhe sodla jao after environment it without hazardous to the or without danger to the human being First objective to manage water discharge from the homes business and industries to reduce the threat of water pollution okay so the second objective that is we can manage of water discharge from the home business and the industries to reduce the their threat is nothing but as a pollutant for water pollutions okay now which we will see here Now, waste characterization. So, waste characterization is a term used for the process of determining the chemical, biological, and the physical characteristics. Mostly, waste characteristics of any industrial water which is focused on the three characteristics that is, chemical, biological, and the physical characteristic of that particular water which is called as a waste characterization, as well as quantity, mass flow rate, strength in terms of concentration, and the discharge. Of schedule of the wastewater team year discharge or a solid wastewater stream also so mostly waste characteristics of wastewater which is focus on the three term that is physical biological and the chemical this is very very important so mostly characterization is basically kasha depend asta ki teen terms var ek asta physical term second asta केमिकल टर्म्स आणि फोर्थ कोण असतं बायोलॉजिकल हे तीन कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आपण वेस्ट वॉटरचे आपण आयडेंटिफाय करू शकतो नाव सॅम्पलिंग नाव वॉट एक्झॅक्टली मिनिंग ऑफ सॅम्पलिंग देन विल डिस्कस ऑन यू हाऊ टू टेक द सॅम्पल द फाउंडेशन ऑफ द स्टडी इज सॅम्पल अँड अनालिसिस ऑफ द प्रोग्राम सो इन डिटेल स्टडी ऑफ वेस्ट वॉटर वी रिक्वायर्ड सम सॅम्पल विच इज केम फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट वॉटर अँड इफ यू टेक द सम वॉटर amount of some water for the laboratory treatment or laboratory experimental purpose At that time, the amount, some amount of the in wastewater, which is called as a sampling, and basically that sample which is required to study is the sample and analysis of the program, which must be performed and the representative samples. The equipment used to measure rate flow and that physically obtained sample must be appropriate to the application and accurately calibrated. So sampling, it is the process used to select a small proportion of the wastewater. Just I told you about that. Sampling is what? Sampling is the process used to select a small portion of a water or a wastewater for the purpose of determining the characteristic of an entire batch of the water wastewater treatment. So in the Marathi we can see the sampling म्हणजे काय खूप कमी प्रमाणातलं वॉटर किंवा वेस्ट वॉटर घेतलेलं जातं की त्याचे कॅरेक्टराइज फाइंड करण्यासाठी आणि त्याच्यावरून आपण इंटर प्लांटचा किंवा इंटर इंडस्ट्रीजचा आपण वेस्ट वॉटरची काय कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक आहे हे आपण आयडेंटिफाय करू शकतो बाय टेकिंग सम सॅम्पल्स. नाव यू नो दॅट हिअर द हाऊ वॉट आर द सॅम्पलिंग. But when we take the sample from the industrial waste or the water treatment, there are some location. From that location, if you take a proper sample, it will be good for the determining the its characteristics. The location from which we can take sample will of course depend on the what we want to discover about the water. So location of the sample is that the matter what is what. So what exactly we discover, what we exactly determining. For that purpose, it depends on the location of the sampling. Example, कोणते sample घेण्यासाठी आपल्याला कशासाठी sample घ्यायचे, काय find करण्यासाठी sample घ्यायचे, त्याच्यावर location depends असते. Example जर बघितलं आपण, operator take a sample of raw water to determining water characteristic, which will be influence treatment procedure. Then they take sample of finished water to determine the how well to treatment worked. Okay, mostly the operator take a sample from the raw water. Which is from the character, which is from the determine the characteristic, which will be influence treatment procedure, and take sample finished water that determining how well the treatment worked. And this is all the example one. Then we can select the sampling point here. Sample from channels are taken at 2/3 and the depth of flow at a point free from the back eddies. Okay, sample from channel. Okay, sample from channel are taken 2/3 depth. Okay, so you know that 2/3 depth, that means if you want to take the sample at a particular point, it should be a 2/3 depth of that particular units and flow at point 4 through the back eddies. Okay, now sample of digester sludge are collected. Now there are the one digester sludge. The sample of digester sludge are collected at 3 to 5 feet. If you take the sample from the digester sludge at that time, the collected it from the 3 to 5 feet intervals, starting at the top and working down, avoid exiting the sludge from which the succeeding sample are the taken. Now this is about sampling location and sampling point, so which is purely depend on what we are going to determining. All that process, sampling size and sampling location will depend on it. Then types of sampling or samples. Okay. So there are the very very important questions or very very important types which will be exam point of view. You can see here there are the two types of sampling mostly. One is a grab sample and second is a composite sample. Okay, many times asked in this particular question in the exam, what are types of sampling? The first is the grab sample, second one is the composite sample. So one by one we can see here grab sampling. The what meaning of grab sample? We can see a grab sample is just what it in a sound like. All of this material is collected at one time. Okay, grab sampling just what the sound like. Okay, all the test material is collected at one time. Suppose that we want to take the different type of test in the laboratory and we require the sample, particularly in the as per the previous I just told you what types of characterization we do we are going to find out. For that purpose we can take the sample. But in a grab sample, just we take in one time one sample for the oil test, okay, which is all as a grab sample. If the sample you want to take a prathek experiment karu shakto asha sampling la apla grab sample only. As such, grab sample reflect performance only at the point in time that sample was collected. Okay, and then only if the sample was properly collected. The grab sample reflect for 4 months only at that time point, in that time the sample was collected. So that is the way to take the grab sample. How to take the way, how to take the grab sample, that is some ways to take the grab samples. We can see here no special equipment is needed. So there is no any special equipment needed to take a grab sample. Usually sampling container is used to take the samples. Usually we can use the sample container and take that sample. The container can be dipped directly into the water, or the sample rod can be used to collect the water sample and fill the container. So particularly taking this grab sample, you directly dip into the water, wastewater, by using the some rod of the container and used to collect water in the fill of the container. Sample are then packed in the collar box with ice and taken for the testing. Okay, after taking sample from the particular unit of the particular wastewater, then it can be packed with some assembly, and it can be keep in the cooler box with the ice and taken from the testing. Grab sampling is used to provide information about water at point in that time. So particular grab sample used to what? Provide information about that water 1 point in a time. So you can see here, this is a rod and this is a one types of a container through which we can take in the container. Okay, you can see here, this is a one of the equipment which you are general equipment which can be take the sample from here by using this rod. This is a way to of taking a sample. The grab sample has certain limitations. So what are the limitations we can see here? In short, a grab sample takes a snapshot of the characteristics of the water at the specific point and the time. Okay, particularly what grab sample is take snapshot for what characters of particular location of the point which can be find the characteristics. So it may not be completely representative of the entire flows. Okay, so it that is may not be completely representative of the entire flows. Grab sample are most appropriate to small plant with a low flow and the limited staff who cannot perform the continuously sample. So it's a very useful for the small plant with the low flow and the limited staff who cannot be performed the continuously of sample. On the other hand, grab sample do provide and the immediate sample and are thus the prefer for the some test. Once you've taken the grab sample immediately and taking the some test, that will be the very effective. So specially pH, diesel oxygen and the total residual chlorine can be changed very rapidly in the water. Once the sample is removed from the flow, so grab sample are preferred for this test only. Once you can take the grab sample and immediately taking a test or doing a test of pH, diesel oxygen and the total residual, they will be give the good result. But after a time interval cannot be give the good result, diesel oxygen, the residual chlorine and pH especially. Grab sample must be collected carefully to make them as representative as possible of the wastewater as a whole. They should be taken at a time of a day when the plant is operating near its averagely daily flow rates. If grab sample are used to determining plant efficiency by the collecting a raw water sample and the treated water sample, then the collection of effluent should be delayed long enough after collection of effluent sample to allow for the raw water to pass completely through the treatment process. This is about the grab sampling or its limitations. Now finally, be aware that mixing two or more grab sample may not result in the result which average the characteristics of the sample. Finally, one grab sample which taking the good result and after mixing of the two grab sample which is not resulting good characteristics of that particular wastewater. Chemically reaction can take place in mix of sample which alter pH and the chlorine residual values. Now second one sample, that is composite sample, that is very important. First just we see here what are the grab sample, what their limitation, how to take grab sample, where are the locations, their limitation just we see in about a grab sample. Now we discuss about composite sample. Composite sampling involves taking a number of small samples called सब सैंपल ओवर पीरियड ऑफ अ टाइम. तो जनरली कंपोजिट सैम्पलिंग इनवॉल्व टेकिंग नंबर ऑफ स्मॉल सैंपल्स. ओके, नंबर ऑफ स्मॉल सैंपल व्हिच इज टेकिंग हियर which is called as a subsample over period of the times. Okay, after some time or over period of the time taken the number of sample which is called as a composite sampling. A composite sample consists of collection of numerous individual discrete sample taken at regular interval over period of time usually 24 hours. म्हणजे काय तर 24 घंट्यामध्ये नंबर ऑफ रेडनी किंवा टाइम इंटरवलने घेतलेल्या स्मॉल अमाऊंटचे सॅम्पल्स जे असतील नंबर ऑफ सॅम्पल घेतलेले असतील व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज अ कंपोजिट सॅम्पलिंग. द मटेरियल बिंग सॅम्पल इज कलेक्टेड इन द कॉमन कंटेनर. मोस्टली कंपोजिट सॅम्पल मटेरियल कलेक्ट इन द कॉमन कंटेनर ओव्हर द सॅम्पल पिरियड. ओके, द अनालिसिस ऑफ दिस मटेरियल कलेक्टेड ओव्हर अ पिरियड ऑफ द टाइम will therefore represent the average performance of wastewater treatment plant during the collection of the period. Mostly in the 24 hours, in the time interval, will be taking the number of numerous sample in particular unit through which they are conducting a test. We can identify what are the performance of wastewater treatment plant during the collection of the period. So you can see here the several graph sample which is taking this different time intervals. Okay, so this is what this is the time intervals exactly 12 o'clock, and they can the number of numerous sample and keep it in one container. This is combined to form of the composite sample. That's why I put here that simple picture. The number of numerous sample water sample collect in the one unit which is called as a combined or composite samples. In composite sample, the greatest strength of composite sample is their ability to take into account change in the flow and other characteristics of the water over the times. So over the times, you can easily characteristics or what are the flow of change in that particular wastewater or wastewater treatment. That's why it's the greatest strength of the composite water sampling. This helps to the operator again overall picture of the total effect that influent will have. Treatment process that will be influent will have on the receiving water. However, composite sample cannot be used for the test of water characteristic which change the during storage, such as dissolved gases or the water characteristics which will change in the sample of mixed together, such as the pH. Especially if we have to find pH and dissolved oxygen and the different chemical characteristics, at that time composite sample cannot be used. Okay, particularly what are the different characteristics in the different times hours? That's why we compute sample were taken here. Okay, so this is about today's lecture. Just in today's lecture, what we learn about? We learn about what exactly industrial waste, meaning of industrial wastewater, the source of industrial wastewater, and then most important, that is types of sample. Whatever exactly meaning of sample is to be seen here, then we seen here types of sampling, that means a graph sampling and composite sampling. So what are exact meaning of graph samples, what are the limitations we seen here today, and the second one and last one, types of sampling, that is composite sampling, and just we seen in detail what are the sampling, how to take it, what are the characteristic or for what the composite sample can be used here. Thank you very much.